Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord,
everyone.
Praise the Lord.
Well, first of all, I want to say thank you, Pastor, and for having me and making me feel so welcome every time I do come. Thank you very much. And I'm glad to see that my pastor's here, and I call him a pastor. I got a bunch of them. And I thank you, the Pastor Young and other ones that's coming out from out of town came and just took time to come. And I was looking at, because I'm going to sing a song that I wrote. And it was one of the rougher times of my life. And it's called, I Trust You. You know, God, I trust you. And I was watching this young man play the drum. I said, I sure hope you got some energy to play for me. I said, dog. I mean, I like that. And your pastor, I'm telling you, he just loses it. That's what I like. I mean, everybody keep with Jesus anyway. Let go. Enjoy yourself. I'm a party tonight. Amen. I'm a party in Christ tonight. You're going to party with me, am I right?
Amen.
I don't want no sin people. No. Hallelujah. No. Hallelujah.
Okay?
All right. Well, I'm going to sing the song. My mic on, baby? Okay. I'm going to sing it, and they're going to play. Now, I wrote the song, even at one of the rougher times of my life, but it sure helps to have some jam behind you.
Amen.
Boy, they can blow. I mean, they play beautifully. Hallelujah. I just leave this here, sweetheart. If you want to play, you too, huh, brother. Okay.
I trust you.
sermon before, and I said, well, Lord, I'm just preaching to Shawnee. I preached it in Isabella, Theodosia. And I said, Lord, because he hears me a lot of them. I said, I want something different. He said, they ain't heard it. He said, they need to hear what I'm giving. I don't pick the sermons. God does. So, hold up. I need to use this, right, huh? Yes. Okay. Before we do anything, this was the book I was telling you about, the testimonies of, the pastor was saying, the testimonies of Brenda Townsend. It tells about raising the dead, but in chapter 2, now when you write a book, you can't put everything in it. You got to condense it, okay? And the chapter 2, if you order it, it's on Amazon.com and Kindle. But if you order it and you read it, the chapter 2, it was when God was bringing me out of a poverty mentality. And God literally stood in front of me. Well, kind of back a little bit. I didn't see his face, but it was his body. And he began to point, and he said, the jewels is yours. The rubies is yours, you know? He said, I made this world. And he had the world in his hand. It was upside down. And there's jewels and diamonds and rubies and sapphires. I believe that's in the Red Sea today, if I'm not mistaken. But when he was talking to me, that's not going to show that in the book. It just kind of condensed it. His breath was blowing in my face. And my hair was blowing back. And that's when he took me in a vision. That's what he wanted to get it into my spirit. Lack don't live here anymore. because when you're coming out of poverty mentality, you have a tendency to live like that. I've been like that all my life. Oh, but God. I ain't like that today. And we don't have to live in the past. Oh, but God, I'm totally changed. Because what? Fear don't live here no more. Unforgiveness don't live here anymore. Lack don't live here anymore. Sickness don't live here anymore. Come on. Worry don't live here anymore. Envy don't live anymore. Pride don't live here anymore. Jealousy don't live here anymore. Only one who lives here is the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Well, now, so when you read that, you'll know that, but his breath was blowing on my face. I'll never be the same. I want someone, we're going to... I plan on talking about grace makes faith takes, but someone turned to Acts 16, verses 22 to 30. Now, level with me. How many in here been praying and believing for years and years and standing, trusting God, and when you haven't got the answer yet, you get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to answer? Raise your hand. Come on now. If I could, I'd raise my feet. You know what I'm saying? But I got some good news for you tonight. We're going to break that. And we're going to talk about Paul and Silas. Acts 16, verses 22 to 30. Acts 16, verses 22 to 30. And I'm going to bring this home. And I promise you, by tonight, if you can agree with me and believe with me, everything that you've been wanting and the stuff you've been under is about to be released tonight. Well, how do you know? Because I said so, Mark 11, 23. You can have whatsoever you say. Don't make me believe alone. Help me to have faith. Work with me. Okay? Because I have faith for you. I really do. I mean, I can honestly say out of debt, all your needs are met. Plenty more to put in stone. Hallelujah. Yes. Okay. Somebody read this for me. I'm going to put you to work. Verse 22 to 30. Will someone read that for me, please? 16, 22 to 30. Okay, go ahead.
And the multitude rose up together against them, and the magistrates rent off their clothes and commanded to beat them. And when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely, who, having received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast.
Paul and Silas. Go ahead, baby.
And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately all the doors were opened and everyone's bands were loosed. And the keeper of the prison, awaking out of his sleep and seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had been fled. But Paul cried with a loud voice, saying, "Do thyself no harm, for we are all here." Then he called for a light and sprang in and came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas and brought them out and said, "Sir, what must I do to be saved?"
Okay, that's good enough. Father, we give you glory. We give you honor. Now move me out of the way, Your Highness. Anything that ain't right in the spirit want to try to hide, you got to go. And no one's welcome in here but the anointing. No one's welcome in here but the sovereignty of the Holy Spirit. So Jesus, have thine own way. Cover me with the blood, sir. And don't have me say nothing I shouldn't say. Cover my tongue except what you want said. Have no one here except what you want heard. This is your time, Jesus, not mine. Move me out of the way, sir. Bless from breast to breast and chest to chest. And let it be like a domino effect in here. Because I'm serious. I want answers tonight. They want answers tonight. We're on total agreement, and they're going to get answers tonight. Because God, you're an answer giver. You're a prayer hearer, and you're a burden deliverer. So God, this is our night, and we're going to run with it for the rest of our life. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. If you agree, say amen.
Amen.
I'm going to give you my topic, though. It's responding unnaturally to a natural situation. Responding unnaturally to a natural situation, okay? Now, when they were in jail, okay? Now, if it was me in jail, I'd have been crying. I ain't gonna lie. You know, I don't do that. You know what's going on. You know. I mean, that's natural. You know, because when we're mistreated or something is wrong, the first thing we'll speak is the problem, and not the promise. Okay? We do natural things like that. Or like if you get real sick, you say, "Oh God, I ain't gonna make it." Oh God, you know. Instead of saying, "Ah, oh, by His stripes." Wait a minute. I'm healed. I don't go there. You know what I'm saying? So these guys, they hadn't, hear the story. They hadn't done anything wrong. They were innocent. But see, if you want to get supernatural miracles, you got to speak unnaturally in a natural situation. That was a natural situation to be in jail. Wasn't nothing spiritual about that. They were in jail. Wasn't nothing spiritual. They were in jail. But they could have said, "Wait a minute, y'all done beat me. I haven't done a thing. My back is bleeding. I'm not happy here. I am not happy here." But what did they do? Hallelujah. They did not speak about the problem they were in. They spoke about the promise that they know. Okay? And they spoke unnaturally in a natural situation. That's when they start saying, "Well, instead of complaining, I'm innocent." They start singing. One sang and one praised. Now, can we be real? Let's be on the down low. How many of us, if we were in jail, would we be singing and praising?
Yeah.
I'm gonna tell you about my mom. Pastor Jeff called the saints. I want to get out of here. I ain't did nothing. Can we be real with this? But they didn't. But see, that's what we need to start doing. I'll get back into that. We need to start speaking unnaturally in natural situations. And how do I know? Like, what's a good example? Okay, let's just say I don't have the money for the rent. This is an example. I'm fine. This is an example. Check it. Okay. Let's say I don't have the money for the rent, and they're supposed to evict me tomorrow. Instead of speaking naturally in a natural situation, first you'll say unnaturally, "My God provides." Hallelujah. Greater is He that's in me than he that's in the world. I refuse to worry. I got the mind of Christ. My God is big. Anything I need, God can't lie. He promised me. I know I'm lined up, loved up, prayed up, and stayed up. So I know God's going to answer my prayer. And now most people would say, "Oh God, I got to find somewhere to get some money and start sweating blood." Come on. You know, but see, when you speak unnaturally in a natural situation, somehow somebody could knock on your door. It's called supernatural. We're dealing with supernaturally, okay? God can do anything. We don't realize as a whole how big God is. We have to start realizing it. And you can't say, "Oh, I just know the Lord. I know Him." Do you really? Do you know that you know that you know that you know that you know? When you start noticing at the bottom in your belly, nothing can take precedence of that. I will never be the same. The devil will never get me down no more like he had me. That is so past tense. It's so past tense. And I admit, whom the Son made free is free indeed. I'm free. I'm free. And how you know? Because I said so. I'm walking in total freedom. Just like it was 2 or 3 weeks ago, I was in the hospital. And I never had trouble with my heart in my life. And I had to go to the hospital that night. They just kept me there until the next day, and I went home. And they told me that possibly I have to go up in my groin and whatever and put a stent in my heart. You know, because I don't know what the deal was. And I said, "What brought me here?" And she said, "You have your magnesium in your heart went too low." And you know, so they put 2 bags of magnesium. I've never had heart trouble. And when they said, and the nurse came in, and she said, "Well, Miss Townsend, you had a stress test and things, and if it didn't turn out good, you're going to have to keep you." And I told her, I said, "I'm going home in Jesus' name. I'm going home. Hallelujah. See, I speak the promise, not the problem. See, I know that I know that I know. And see, people say you're cocky when you stand up and say you know. No, you're convinced. Ain't nothing cocky about who you know. You need to start speaking it out. Now folks ain't gonna like it. Whatever. I sleep good tonight, honey. I'm a spiritual hog. If y'all don't want it, it's gonna come back on me. Y'all be skinny as a bird. Y'all better take y'all's blessing because I'll take it. Ain't nobody playing. I'm getting mad. Okay. Tell me back there, you ain't getting mine. I'm only kidding, sweetheart. Jesus. But you know what? When you have joy in the midst of trouble, when you don't know what you're gonna do, but you can laugh, you can praise God. If that ain't saying volumes to God, then I trust you, even though I can't trace you. Sometimes you don't feel like preaching. Sometimes I don't. We go through so much, but I always say two words: but God. But God. And when that doctor Campbell, she was an elderly lady, beautiful lady, it was precious. She came up to me and she said, "So, Mrs. Townsend, we'll have to let you know about the report if you can leave or not." I said, "Oh, I'm going home in Jesus' name." And I was very nice. And then she got ready to walk out and then she looked at me. She said, "There's something about the name of Jesus. Something about the name of Jesus." When you say that name, everybody got to bow. Everybody got to say, "Hey, what's up, Jesus?" Hallelujah. And when I told that lady that, I was laying on my back. And then I said, "Oh, I'm going home, sweetheart, in Jesus' name." She got ready to walk out the door. She was an elderly lady, precious, an elderly doctor. And she stopped and she turned around. She said, "I'm so glad I met you." She stuck out her hand and I said, "God bless you, I'm glad I met you too." I said, what was that about? He said, "She got a hold of my name." Hallelujah, she got a hold of my name. We need to start bragging on Jesus. Amen. Not ourselves. We start, you know, it ain't about us anyway. And when we die, we're gonna be just a dirt. So why would you be all adding some chips with special dips? It's Jesus. It ain't about us, it's about Jesus. Now, here's the part I want you to get. I am so excited. Okay. Now just get excited because this is going to bless your knee socks off when you ain't got none on. Okay, now. Hold up. Yes, this is so cool. Give me five. Okay. Isn't it good to be free? Yes. I am so happy. I hope I'm not getting on your nerve, but I can be happy. Hallelujah. I'm sorry, you know, because all of those shots, I'm free. Amen. Oh my God. Well, what are you free from? From me. I'm from people. I'm free, hallelujah. I'm free from worry. And this is the part that I like about that, Acts 16. When they start singing, instead of complaining, they start praying. You know, hey, you know, they were singing and wasn't complaining. You know, they were praying and they wasn't playing. You understand what I'm saying? Okay, when they start singing and worshiping God and one was praying, all of a sudden, that's speaking unnaturally in a natural situation. Y'all got that? Okay, that's how the Holy Spirit ushered the supernatural in. See, it's what we say. It's how we react. It's what you do. It's how you speak. It's how you say, "Well, I just give up." It's your attitude, baby. Your attitude determines your attitude. Hallelujah, you need a gratitude. That's what you need. Attitude adjustments here. So, when they start singing, all of a sudden, they heard an earthquake. Earthquake. Right? Would you call that supernatural? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And when it come, what did you rattle the place? Oh my God. The bonds were broken. See, and sometimes we bound up and change from fear. Pride, jealousy, whatever the heck it is. Get free tonight. Get free. I got no chains on me. Honey, shook them off. I am so free, I get tired of myself. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know y'all probably died, whatever. Okay. All right. Check this. Y'all just have to excuse me. I feel so light, honey. I do. Have you ever in here been so free and God blessing you so much you don't want to do it yourself? Has that ever happened to anybody? Or always thank you. Always so spiritual all the time. Hey, you know what I'm saying? Okay, here comes the earthquake. Breaking the chains. And then there's more. Because why? Because they spoke unnaturally in a natural situation. Get the root of it. Okay. When they came in, chains were broken, doors were open, and they could have left, right? But let me show you some more about this man called Jesus, okay? and the anointing and the favor of God and His power and His peace, hallelujah, and His might and His strength. Nobody left.
That's true.
I'd have been booking. No. Them doors open. Hey!
I know, thank you, Jesus.
It's true, though, you know? No one wanted to leave the presence of God. Even though they were behind bars, hallelujah. There was more freedom behind bars than outside. Come on now. But then the best thing, which was, it topped it. The jailer, hallelujah, he was going to kill himself. And Paul said, hold up. Don't do that, boo. Don't do that. I'm speaking demonically, okay? He said, you ain't got to go there. Now, he was going to kill himself. He said, we're out here. And then he saw the miracle of God. He saw the power of God. And he saw the love of God in him. Because he could have said, yeah, you're going to get killed today, boy. But he said, we're not going anywhere. Don't kill yourself, sir. And his love moves the multitude. Love covers the multitude. Love can break any door down. Hallelujah. Now, when they showed that poor jailer some love, he said, here's the bottom line of it all. What must I do to be saved? Yes. Healing is good. Yes. Even in my book, I talk about raising the dead. When the Lord having to raise the dead in 99, that's great. Salvation is number one. Yes. Grabbing folks out of the vices and pit of hell, that's number one.
Yes.
That dude got saved. Turned around. Took them to the house, wiped their backs off, and treated them like kings that they were. All because of what? Speaking unnaturally. Say it with me. Unnaturally in natural situations. In natural situations. Speaking, say it again. Unnaturally in natural situations. Now, I'm just going to put it's like a little smorgasbord. Grace makes faith takes. We know we hear it all the time, don't we? Jesus gave us healing and stuff over 2,000 years ago. We hear that, right? And we have to have the faith. This is what I got the revelation of. When we ask God, yes, sir, I will. When we ask God over and over and over, we could be praying in unbelief and didn't know it. What do you mean? Lord, I need this. See, when grace already made the way, all you go, Lord, I thank you, it's made, and take it. Faith takes it. If you keep asking over, now let's say, Jeff, you and your honey, have me over for dinner. I'm going to give you a good example. And then you say, Sister Towns, Sister Brenda, the food's on the table. And then I say, is the food on the table? And then you say, yes, it is, Sister Brenda. So I come back. Is the food on the table? Then I'm going to come one more time, and I know that's going to really kick him off. Brother Jeff, I know, right? You're tired of me already, I'm sorry. And then they say, is the food on the table? And you're going to look and you're going to say, I ain't answering no more. Can we talk? You're going to get tired of somebody asking you the same dumb question over and over. Well, if we get tired of it and we won't answer, what about Jesus? Hallelujah. God is waiting on us to take what He already put there. Now, He didn't put the food on the table. Ain't got to worry about me asking twice, brother. You know, I'm going to take it, hallelujah. God has been waiting on us to quit asking them the same questions over and over and over. Amen. Take it.
Amen.
Are you getting it? I've done it. I was ignorant of that. I didn't really know. And we don't mean any harm when we're praying the same thing. But honey, it's time to quit praying the same stale prayers and take what He's given you and watch what He does.
Amen.
We keep asking, well, Lord, will you heal me? Lord, where my man? Where my wife? You know what I'm saying? Where my money? You know something. Jesus, where that? And Jesus on the throne, I ain't answering. I done told you, sister, girl, brother, man. I done told you over 2,000 to 4,000 years ago. It's already been done. Grace has made the way already, y'all. All God wants us to do is take it by faith. Start taking it, baby. Quit asking for the same thing. Y'all want to know why your prayers ain't being answered? Because you've been asking for the same thing over and over and over. I don't do that no more. I've done it myself. I'm not being critical. I'm trying to help you. Stop asking and start taking. But how do we take it by faith? You open your mouth and say, Lord, I thank you. I received this by faith. I thank you. I got my Holy Ghost filled good looking husband. Hey, I ain't got no poor, no ugly man. Hey. Feel good about it. discuss, the show can't be trusted. I'm done. And you, hey, let's do this. And then, now if you want a beautiful wife, you don't want no drag nasty hair, baby. Want a good looking woman that loves God. Got a lot of class. You don't want nobody, hey, what's your name? Don't nobody need that. I'm just saying, I'm looking at these couples and everything. Y'all on top of y'all look good. Ain't no ugly people in here. all these fine looking brothers and sisters and everything. See, y'all looking good. God's blessed you. God will give you your heart's desire if you will believe, decree, receive, and take it. Don't get mad at God when he don't answer. And you know, because of what, just like I told you, anybody else here, if I keep asking you, just like, baby, if you say, I want you to come over, I got a gift for you. And then I'll ask you, you got a gift for me? And you say, yeah. You got a gift for me, Lisa? Yeah. You got a gift? Not no more. I'll give it to somebody else with some sense. Can we talk? So now, it's funny. And I said in a comical way, but we've been doing that to Jesus for years. Amen. For a lifetime. Yes. I know I have. Yes. Now tonight is your deliverance night. Amen. You hear me? Yes. Things you've been wanting all your life. Things you've been believing for all your life. Yes, sir. Intimate personal desires that's lined up with God all your life. You're going to get them now. Yes. Well, how am I going to get it? Because you're going to open your mouth and start praising God in advance.
Thank you, Jesus.
Start praising them in advance. Hallelujah. Wait, I just don't see it, will it? You don't ever get it, honey. Because you got to believe. You can't see first. You got to believe first. Because, and people say it all the time, and I did too. Girl, I know the word says. Over 2,000 years ago, he paid the price, and he did. For our healing, for our money, for everything, right? We say that, but did we believe it? No. Did I? No, but I do now. And as I begin to speak, as I'm talking this, it's getting in your spirit. Right down to your gut, to your mind, body, soul, and spirit. I'm believing that. Well, how do you know? Because I said so. I can have whatsoever I say. Now, they say, well, you're so cocky. No convince, Sister Gumby. Just convinced. Don't let nobody steal your praise. Don't let nobody steal your joy. As God blesses you, rejoice and run with it. Tell the world how good God is. But I don't like her. She always got something. That's why you poor, broke, disgusted, and busted. And she okay? Can't be trusted. And then you're going to get mad at somebody else's blessing? God got the same for you. If you will line up with God, show the love, and live right. Uh-oh. Live right. Uh-oh. You can't live like hell and expect heaven's best. Watch out. Have a nice day. Bye. Because I'm going to say it anyway. I will not compromise to please you, not even for myself. It's about Jesus. It's all about him. Get that in your spirit. You understand? It's time for us to quit looking at us because we all dancing some chip and dip. No, it's about Jesus. Now, I believe in, there's been sickness on people's body. I sure will, Lord. A lot of people say, now I'm 67 years old, and people say, you have so much joy. I said, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Amen. What you want me to do? Amen. Wear bucket shoes and look crazy? No. I know, right? He said, man, you never come back again. No, just kidding. You don't want me to wear some gray oxygen with a gray wig and come in, drag that, huh? You know, no. I'm going to come in, la. He gives you strength.
Yes.
He gives you power. Yes. He gives you joy. Yes. He gives you peace. I got all that, baby. I got all that. Yes. And you know, a lot of folks don't like me. I have more to love me than dislike me. But the ones who don't like me, you know what I say? That's your loss, boo. That's your loss. Don't try to please people. It'll never work. Please Jesus. And you'll always know. He'll never let you down. And you know what? Jesus is good enough to send people into your path that'll help you.
Amen.
That'll serve you. That's why I'm here tonight. I'm here to serve you. And I'm here to serve you. And we're going to get some answers tonight. Yes, ma'am. Give me your hand. Hopelessness, die in Jesus' name. Peace. To my sister. Oh, no. No hopelessness here. This is the day the Lord has made, and my girl going to rejoice and be glad in it. Hopelessness, die. Sometimes you don't even want to hardly live, but the devil is a liar. Jesus, still the Messiah. As I lay hands on your heart, young woman of God, young woman, youth is renewed like the eagles. I'm giving the word. Young woman, hope, faith, he shall take it, baby. Take the peace. Take the joy. Take your life back in Jesus' name. Give him praise. Girl, when I hustled in the Lord, when I was walking, and I can feel the pull. It was just dragging. And that was not God. It was just dragging. When it just take you down. Guess what? We got news for him. He's been evicted. He does not belong here. And this whole church, Satan has been evicted. He does not belong here. The whole church. Not only you, the whole church. Oh, you better start getting angry. Not at the people. Getting at the enemy. I mean, when folks is at each other, I can't stand you, I don't like you. That ain't nothing but a spirit. Get rid of that mess and start loving. Yeah. All I have to say is for fun, there's a lot of folks who hear this. I'm not kidding. They don't like me and jealous because I don't compromise. I don't argue with them. I say, Lord, show them themselves and I'll move on. I'm going to guard my heart with all diligence. I'm going to make sure I treat you right. I'm going to make sure I treat, and if you don't treat me right, that's on you, baby. God's my battle axe. That's why I can do what I do in the name of Jesus. And I want to lay hands on folks who want to be laid on today. I want you to start speaking unnaturally in natural situations. Okay? Remember that grace already made the way, but walking it by taking it by faith. Don't ask him no more. I've been asking him to heal me for 50 years and I ain't going to get healed, clown. You're still asking the same thing over and over. Take it. What's up with that? Take it. Thank you. I mean, when my heart, and I never had no trouble with that, it hit me. It kind of made me nervous. I'm not going to lie. But I had to speak unnaturally in a natural situation. My friend came to see me from Eufaula, and I was laying on my back. Let me tell you this. What's in you going to come out? And I had a fever and everything. And she came to see me. And her name is Bobby. She sat there, and she looked at me. And I can tell she, because she hugged me, and I was, she said, you got a fever. And she was really worried for me. And I was laying on my back, and I looked at her. I said, Bobby, I might be laying on my back, but my spirit is standing tall.
Amen.
Get your spirit alive. Spirit is always perfect. Raise it. Head on up, Oshaya. Get your spirit alive, honey. Walk after the spirit, not after the flesh. Yeah, but I'm around 80 years old, and ain't no age in Christ. Ain't no age in Christ. And I'm not telling you 80 years old and to go down on the school to chew and bubble gum. I ain't saying act a fool. I didn't say that. But I just want you to recognize who you are. Recognize who Jesus is. Quit saying you know him when you're not walking in him. Amen. Yeah, no. Quit saying you know him when you're not walking in him. Well, how do you walk in him? With obedience and love. With obedience and love. Quit criticizing. Oh my God. It's hot. Quit criticizing. You might not understand this or that about somebody else. Let their God's property live alone. I don't know why I'm saying that, but they're God's property. And I don't like you saying that, but then you guilty. You guilty. Because anybody that's really serious about changing and might step on your toes or hit you, first they're going to say, Lord, I thank you. If you're serious about this thing, if you're serious. How many serious? Raise your hand. How many believe? Now, as I was, yes, sir, I hear it, sir. Thank you. As I was talking, the Holy Ghost was talking through me. He said he was imparting some things in your spirit. How many feel better? And I ain't prayed yet. Seriously. Yeah, because he's imparting in you. Thank you for receiving it. Because it means the world to me for you to have what God has. But if you don't want it, I love you. I'm taking mine. And then someone, well, I don't want it. I'll take yours. Spiritual hog. I'm a hog after the blessings of God. Be like Tim. You ain't taking mine, Jack. I don't want to take nothing, but if you're giving it away, I'll take it. If you're giving it away, I'll take it. I want to pray. Yeah, yeah. Ah, that is sure. A lot of past. Okay, I'll say it. A lot of people have been living in the past and struggling. Haven't had a good past. And you've been struggling, not for days, for years. For years. One thing you got to forgive the folks and then forgive yourself. You want to be delivered tonight? You better come on up here and act like it. Because I ain't going to beg nobody to pray for him. I love him. And I want daddy to bless you. But if you don't want to come up, sit there. I'm going to share that. I'm going to do it. Okay. Give me your hands. A lot on your mind. You think a lot pretty near all the time. I'm going to teach you to rest in me. Because you love me, you will agree. A lot of things been on your mind day after day, but the devil's still a liar anyway. He will not keep you down, nor your spirit too. All you do is have to rely on me, and I'll bring it through. The thoughts that keep tormenting your mind sometimes, son, you got to realize God has already won. Stick with him, hold his hand, and you continue to take your Holy Ghost stand, saith the Lord. Give him praise. You're not defeated. You're more than a conqueror. You don't ever have to put your head down. You're more than a conqueror. I don't know who in here ain't failed. You're more than a conqueror. Amen. You're the head. Stand, baby. They need you. You're the head. God said stand. They need what you got. You ain't no fool in the spirit. Take it, baby. Run with it. Not only will you help your family, you help other people too. We got to be men and stand. We got to be women and stand. My, my. All I'm hearing tonight is healing, 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 healing. Physically, spiritually, and mentally. Physically, spiritually and physically. And when you get that spiritually and physically, that's right, emotionally too. Your emotions need to be dealt with. They're out of whack. And that emotional, they're out of whack. Because sometimes you don't know where you're coming and going. The devil is a liar. Jesus is still the Messiah. Emotions need to be in God. Your emotions are. A lot of your emotions just up and down because you're going through something and you don't even know what to do and your emotions just out of whack. Time to get in line. How many want to be in line? Because I ain't begging nobody. I'm just asking, sweethearts. How many admit that they have emotions out of whack and you need to get in line? Yes, sir. Thank you. And the rest of y'all, when I raise my hand, I'm going to cast a line. That was Atlanta. Yes, ma'am. Now I'm going to take my shoes off and get ready to get busy. So much for being cute. do you have any, not fast music, because it got to be conducive with the spirit. Do you have praise, some kind of praise music? Soft? Y'all have that? Do they have that? Okay, I'd like that, please. Thank you. How many in here have been hurting and still hurting? From way back and even now, raise your hand. Okay. Now I'm going to ask you a simple question. How many want to be free? Tonight. If you want to be free, come up. Come up. I need some help with you, please. If you want to be free, please come up. As y'all come up, I have to sing something before you play anything. I have a song that God has given about the church. Trials and tribulations too. Trials, you've been wondering what to do. Trials, been going along for a long time. You're still mine, this whole church. God is here, talking about everybody. He's here for you. God is here. He knows what to do. Hold your head up high. You'll not be denied. Hallelujah. God is here. He's here. He's here. voice so much on me, Lord. Jesus. Even my heart is broken. We got broken hearts in here. We really do. We have troubled minds and can't even sleep. And that old shit, sometimes your esophagus won't even digest the food because your stomach's been bothered. It's almost like an ulcer you've been going through so much. We got that in here tonight. I don't want you to leave here with it. I'm done. Thank you. Is everybody here safe? Want to have the altar? Now, son, take it. Now, son, hold in that slow, little muscle. Now, son.
knowledge of the sisters. And she was tired and weary in her spirit. I speak to your spirit, young woman, God's hail to heal woman, God. I change tonight. Oh, yes. All God asking you to do is start talking, sweetheart. And begin to, every time that mess comes out, I'm healed.
Yes.
I give you praise. Speak up. That's been a natural situation. That's the remedy God's able to give you. Just start talking. And I promise you, these things. Because it's already been done. It's made it. Face takes it. Start talking. Okay, sweetheart? And you'll notice a change. That no one's on this line. You're going to feel this thing. You already do.
Start talking.
Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Clear all the mess. Oh my God. I see. Yeah, there you go. Oh yeah, clarity. Deliverance. All the past is history, and your present belongs to God, and so is your future. All this mess, why?
Yes, Lord.
These are God's people. They got a brand new start.
Yes.
Cleansing in the land. It won't shine. Have been through that. We'll be the same. This is it. You've been evicted. You got to go. Take all your little chump friends with you. You got to go. In Jesus' name.
Yes.
God, I release the blood of Jesus to put out the walls. I release the Holy
tonight. And not if it does, since it has, we're going to be responsible for beautiful things going to take place. But it had to change tonight.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Prayer before we dismiss tonight. And I may enjoy it, Sister Brenda, tonight.